Cracker Jack.
A few quiet moments with her two youngest children, Emma Claire and Jack. It's a rare commodity these days for Elizabeth Edwards. With Super Tuesday quickly approaching, Mrs. Edwards is hitting the campaign trail hard. She is perhaps her husband's best weapon, a combination of Southern charm and sharp intellect. A one-time lawyer, she is convinced her husband is the man to boot George Bush out of office.
Not just free trade.
The man who can nab those Dean voters.
John's perspective is one that actually starts with the American people, as opposed to starting with him. Instead of this is about me and what I can do. John often talks, as Howard Dean did, this is about you and what we both can do together. He hasn't been in politics forever. And what that means is he brings more of a real life, everyday view to things.
Is there one particular moment, one shining moment that stands out from your mind from the time on the campaign, people you've encountered and people you've met?
When I was in Wisconsin, someone had seen John at an event in Sheboygan, and he wanted to give me, for John, his ribbon from Desert Storm. And so in this small plastic bag was this ribbon. Now that plastic bag is in John's pocket, and he carries it with him everywhere.
Education is a cornerstone of Edwards' vision for the future. When their eldest child, Wade, died 8 years ago, they worked through their devastation, in part by establishing an after-school tutoring program in his memory. It's a program, she says, should be nationwide.
We talk about equality as one of the real values of this country, but if we don't believe in educational equality for our children, those are just words we're using. We need to make a real commitment to it, and John honestly believes that.